Now, from the studios of Into Tomorrow in Miami, this is ITTV.
Hello, tech fans. Welcome back to another Into Tomorrow TV update brought to you by Newegg.com. I'm Dave Graveline. For many people, the summer just can't get here fast enough, especially for all of our radio show listeners and ITTV viewers, because that means it'll be time for the big, cool Into Tomorrow hot summer giveaway. Details coming soon. Stay tuned right here. Do you find yourself listening to internet radio but still having to sit in front of the computer? Well, there are several Wi-Fi radios available that free you up. Rob joins us now with a couple of units that we use right here in our studio.
That's right, Dave. Internet radio has become one of the most popular ways to listen to our favorite radio programming, of course, including Into Tomorrow 24/7. A lot of our radio listeners have asked us to recommend a Wi-Fi radio unit for them. Here we have two of our favorites that we've talked about recently on the show. Let's start with the CC Wi-Fi radio from our friends at C-Crane. It offers more than just internet radio. The CC Wi-Fi radio has built-in speakers, so you won't need to plug it into external speakers unless you want to. You can also connect headphones to it and listen in private. Connecting it to our wireless network was pretty quick. CC Wi-Fi radio can connect to your network with an Ethernet cable as well, so that'll give you a more solid connection. With its built-in media player, you can access and play music on your network, so you can play music that's saved on your computer at home or the office. The CC Wi-Fi radio can store up to 99 of your favorite stations. We certainly hope that Into Tomorrow is one of them. To make it easier, you can access their internet radio database online and search for your station. If you can't find the station you want, you can add it manually online, and it'll be on the radio the next time you turn it on. CC Wi-Fi radio is available for about $200. This is the Aira from Mine Electronics. I was surprised to see how lightweight it is, and then I realized it didn't have any built-in speakers. I was a bit bummed, but it was easy to integrate with your existing speaker system. In fact, they even provide audio cables and an adapter to easily plug it in to the speakers or your entertainment system. Connecting it to our wireless network was a breeze. Aira has a network wizard that helps you set up the wireless connection, almost like the way you connect your laptop to a Wi-Fi. It shows you the available wireless networks and then you put in the network key if required. I was searching for stations and podcasts in about 2 minutes. They have a pretty extensive database too, over 11,000 stations. We like the design on the Aira. It has a nice flush screen and the remote is pretty simple to use. One of my favorite features is how easy you can save a station as a favorite. Aira can hold up to 40 presets and is available under $150. While there are many more Wi-Fi radios available, we hope this helps you narrow down your search for some of the best Wi-Fi options. Of course, you can improve their quality by streaming Into Tomorrow all the time. To learn how to find us on these devices, meet us at intotomorrow.com. That's where Dave is right now.
Hey, thanks, Rob. And yeah, there I am right there on our website. Do you have any questions about the products and technology we discuss on the program? We want to hear from you and send you prizes for joining us. Call anytime on any day 24/7 1-800-899-INTO 800-899-4686. Or if you're participating outside of North America, email us a brief quality MP3 to askdave@graveline.com. Your call could air on the next Into Tomorrow, the radio show, and qualify you for some fabulous prizes. This ITTV Into Tomorrow TV update is brought to you by Newegg.com. Want to save money on electronics? Newegg.com has a daily shell shocker promotion. One shocking deal per day, every day. Visit Newegg.com now for jaw-dropping savings on close to 40,000 tech products. Voted best place to buy online. What FCC ruling changed the TV world forever? Chris Graveline joins us now with his ever-popular This Week in Tech History.
This week in 1880, Francis Clark and M.G. Foster patented the electrical hearing aid. In 1896, this week, the addressograph was patented by J.S. Duncan of Sioux City, Iowa. And this week in 1964, TV sets were drastically different after a ruling by the FCC stated that all TV receivers should be equipped to receive both VHF and the new UHF. As a result, TV dealers scrambled to unload their VHF-only models as fast as possible. That's our look back at This Week in Tech History.
Dealers scrambling to sell their TVs. Kind of sounds a lot like the DTV transition too, doesn't it? Want to stay connected with the latest news from the tech world? Subscribe to our free once-a-week tech newsletter. It's easy. We'll let you know about our exciting giveaways and lots more. In fact, our newsletter subscribers find out first before others. Hint, hint. We hope you enjoyed this week's update. Thanks for joining us into tomorrow. I'm Dave Graveline. Stay tuned.